accessible to people that come from marginalized communities, such as low-income population, new immigrants, and indigenous communities. Some access is restricted because of location, and more often than not, because it is not affordable. When it comes to girls and young women, our society is still delivers a loud message that girls and young women do not have a place in STEM. The gender roles are a major factor in our society, and role models for women in STEM are far and few in between, especially when it comes to Canadian women in STEM. You can't be what you can't see. For that reason, it is not surprising to see that very few young women are aspiring to becoming scientists. While working with marginalized population as a social worker, STEM-related skills were never an option or a solution given to this population. Not many people believe that marginalized population is capable or deserving of quality education, particularly STEM skills, as typically this type of education would be reserved for the elite. I remember a while back running across a quote that motivated me to do the work that I do today. What if the cure for cancer was stuck in someone's mind that cannot afford an education? We can't divide people based on their socioeconomic status. We must unite and work together to make our country and the world a better place. Now, knowing that STEM will become a required skill in the workforce for all populations, I am very motivated to making STEM skills accessible to all girls and young women. Why? Because since Revolution's inception, I have seen that once we break the barrier of high cost, young women are thirsty for quality education and they will show up to learn. Gender roles must be eliminated and girls and young women must be given an environment where they too can explore and experiment with STEM. Government, local organizations, and corporations have a responsibility of making STEM accessible. Highlighting role models in STEM is a great way to get girls and young women excited about STEM. Women who are already in STEM, don't forget to look back and bring with you the next generation of young women who strive to be you someday. No one does it alone, and once upon a time, you receive the help and support of another person who got you where you are today. Programs that are accessible and low cost are a great way again to close the gender gap, and most importantly, making room for marginalized population in STEM is something that must continue to be done. Ask for help from the communities around you, and join forces with organizations who are already doing this important work today. I urge you, everyone here today, to ask yourself, what can I do? And start there. It takes one person to change your world, and who says that it can be you? Thank you.